In this video, we're going to talk about simple functions. Remember that if these kind of videos are helpful for you, then you can donate on Ko-fi to support the channel. Simple functions are a family of functions that are, as the name says, very simple, and will be very useful to prove certain theorems only on this family instead of on a more general family of functions such as continuous functions or measurable functions. To understand them, we first have to understand a specific function called the characteristic function. It's defined with this letter chi, and it's defined over a set E. So we will take E, a set, let's say, in our space X, and now this function on some value X is defined as 1 if X is in E, and 0 if not. It's very easy to see that chi on some set E is measurable if and only if the set itself is measurable. Now these functions, as I said, are called characteristic or indicator functions. Well, simple functions are just linear combinations of indicator functions. And one important thing is that this linear combination will be finite. So a function phi is going to be an indicator function if it's of the form an times chi in en of x, where we will say that n goes from 1 up to some capital N. And the reason why we take a finite linear combination is that we don't want indicator functions to take values plus infinity or minus infinity. So we want them to always be finite, and well, that is obviously guaranteed when we add 1 only a finite amount of times. Now in this linear combination we can see a few things. First of all, we have this coefficient, which is going to be any number, and this number can be taken either on the real numbers or complex, depending on whether we want our function to be real or complex function. And then to define these indicator functions, what we need are sets e1, e2, and so on up to en in our sigma algebra. So given a finite amount of sets in our sigma algebra and some coefficients, we can form a simple function phi. But now, why are these functions so important? I mean, they're extremely simple. Well, they're important because of this next theorem. This theorem says that we have a measurable space X, M, so a set and a sigma algebra. A function that goes from that set to the zero infinity, so it's a positive function. The same can be done if the function is negative. That is measurable. So if you don't remember some of these concepts, I recommend you check out our previous videos in the reproduction list. What the theorem says is that there exists a sequence phi n of simple functions that are increasing, so each function is smaller than the next one, and all of them are smaller than f, and they're all positive, that converge to f pointwise and uniformly on a set where f is bounded. So why is this theorem useful? Well, we know, for example, that continuous functions are measurable. So what this theorem tells us is, well, any continuous function can be approximated pointwise or uniformly on a set where a function is bounded by simple functions, and that is huge. Now we can take any theorem that is valid for continuous functions, and instead of proving it for that huge family, just prove it for simple functions. This will be very helpful for us when we try and do integration theorems. Now the proof for the theorem is actually pretty ugly. So what I'm gonna do is, instead of proving it, because you can find the proof on any book, let's just try and draw how we can approximate a function. The proof is actually building this sequence phi n that will approximate our function. So let's do that, but with a drawing, without all the mathematical notation that's a bit ugly in this case. So let's say that our function f is something like this. Okay, and let's say, just to get a few numbers going, that this number is 2. So this here will be 1. What we want to do is approximate this function f by simple functions. Well, let's start with this number 1. We can just take a set like this. So let's zoom in to see what's actually going on. Now we can see that there are a few regions where the function is greater than 1 and some other regions where it's smaller. Let's say that this is all above 1. So what we're going to do is define a function, a simple function, as 0 when the function is smaller than 1 and 1 where the function is greater than 1. So in this small interval, the function is below the line, so we will take 0. Then here it will be 1 all the way. Well, okay, here we have a simple function. It's just this is going to be the set E1. This other one is E2, this E3, and this last one E4. And then the function is taking the value 1 or 0. It's just going to be the sum of the indicator functions. So this function, let's call it phi1. Now let's build the second function. What we will do is divide each of these two intervals into 1/2. So here we have 1/2 and 3/2. Now when we look at this first interval here, the function is greater than 1/2, so it's going to take the value 1/2. Now in the next one is greater than 1, so it's going to take the value 1. In this one, it's greater than 1/2, so it's just going to be 1/2. But now in this case, we have another separation here, here. So now we have the intervals E1, E2, E3 like before, but this part changes. We have E4, E5, and this last one E6. So now in E4, the function is again going to take the value 1 because it's big greater than 1 but smaller than 3/2. And now in this region, the function is greater than 3/2. So it's just going to take the value 3/2. And now since here is below 3/2 but above 1, it will take the value 1. Well, now this new function is going to be phi2. And well, my plot is not great because here I'm below 2. But if my function was oscillating a bit more, or even not just oscillating but just growing, then you can see how this sequence can be built. So I'm just going to stop here because this is just a drawing, but you can see that in the next step we would have to divide everything by 1/2 again and do the exact same thing we did here. But this drawing is going to be way more complicated, so I'm just going to stop it there and you can follow building phi3 and so on. And this family of simple functions is very easy to see that they will converge pointwise to f and uniformly where the function f is bounded.